number going?
Yes.
Okay. We're going to start out with something which they showed me to do. I have my knees that hurt. You brace yourself against some type of wall. What do you have to do?
Come here, Scout.
And you, want to zoom in a little. You put your hands here, not on your knee, and you push your knee backwards. And if your knees are in pretty rough shape, you want to hold this as long as a couple minutes. In other words, it's not like you're putting a lot of force, but you are pushing backwards to stretch that knee. Seems counterintuitive, but it feels good to me. The next one is a simple one. You put your calf, your foot back, and you're braced against the wall, and then you lean, and you're stretching this Achilles tendon. And then once you've held that, you hold it somewhere between 10 to 30 seconds, whatever the number. You should feel a nice stretch. Shouldn't be painful. Nothing should be painful. Then you come in a little, bend the knee, and go back into the stretch. That's actually a different stretch. And then there's no particular order. I'll do, this is one that might be a little challenging for some of you. You put your hands here, put your knees on your hands, and then you balance. On your hand.
Why don't you come out of that and turn around where people can see you?
Very good. What? They couldn't see me.
Yeah, I always see your butt.
Well.
Turn around.
Draft. That
or do it on the mat.
I don't want to do that. I want it on a firm surface. Mm. Again, you put your hands down. This one's called Crow. I don't know the Sanskrit name. You balance on your hands. Remembering to breathe. But anyway, that's a good pose. Good for concentration. Put your feet out like this. And then you just gently come down. And feel the nice stretch in the old back. This is what I do. Now there's another variation to this.
If you have heart problems, you don't want to lean over like that.
Yeah, okay. Anyway, you support yourself and you're stretching groin area here. This is a nice one. It feels good. And of course, with all of them, I'm not showing both sides. But you do want to stretch both sides. And I'm going to just show you while we're playing around. Cobbler pose. I don't normally do this one, but it's a good pose. You can do it in a lot of different positions. You put your feet together. Now you'll notice instead of laying my head down, I keep my head elevated. I get a little vertigo, so I do better with my head elevated. But again, you feel the stretching in here. It's a good pose. Good pose. Let's do cat-cows. This one's a pretty simple stretch. You come to all fours, and first you go down with your back. Remember to breathe, and then roll up. Now, I don't do a lot of these. You can do as many as you want, but this is a good thing to loosen up your back. Cat and cow. This is the cat. This is the cow. Now, I don't normally do bird dogs. I don't like them. They're a pain. But you can do these things. This is not one I do because I don't have very good balance. But bird dogs are good.
Can we start over?
Okay, stop.